The Bible talks about different ingredients that we need to add to our life in order to make it fruitful. And when we add these ingredients to our lives, when these ingredients are part of our life, Peter writes and he says that our life will be neither barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So he says, add to your faith virtue, knowledge, self-control, and he talks about a quality which is perseverance or endurance. So what is this quality, endurance? It is that ability to press through. It is that ability to keep going. It is that quality that we develop to keep going, to persevere with determination, to overcome all obstacles, as in, you know, living the Christian life each and every day despite all challenges. We will not give up because of circumstances. We will not give in because of persecution. We will not give up because of external pressure, but we will continue on. And there are many life situations which require endurance. You know, for example, when in life, many of the things that we undertake requires time and effort and preparation. Maybe, you know, you're preparing for your exam, or you're preparing for a project, you're preparing for a new assignment. It requires time, it requires effort, it requires preparation. And for all that, we need this quality, endurance. Just because we face a challenge, just because life hits a roadblock, that's not the time to give up. Secondly, when things go wrong, we require endurance or perseverance. Many times things don't go as we plan. There are many times, you know, surprises come, or there are things, circumstances, difficulties come our way and we didn't expect it. It's unexpected when things go wrong. We need to endure, we need to persevere. And there are times when things get delayed. We think, okay, I will do this at a certain time, you know, I will finish this and I will get onto this, I will get this job, I will get this done. But there are times when delays happen and we don't have answers why these delays are there. And for that, we need to persevere, we need to endure. There are sometimes things happen which distract us, which discourage us, and you know, wrongful suffering, or maybe suffering for the name of Christ and so on. So I need to endure. So how is it that we can endure? How is it that we can build this quality in us? Hebrews 12 talks about when we run the race to look at Jesus, to keep our focus on Jesus. So when we do that, we can endure. Secondly, we can anchor ourselves in the promises of God. To anchor ourselves, to really hook on to the promises of God, to make sure that we are anchored, that we are fastened, so that we are immovable. We hold on to the promises of God. And the third thing is to be inspired. We can be inspired by testimonies of what God has done in people's lives. It always inspires us and helps us to persevere, and so on. So we stick to the original vision no matter what, and we persevere. And we're going to pray today, and because there's great reward for endurance. There's great reward, and there is need for endurance in our lives. So let's pray and ask God for this quality to be built in us. Maybe there are some of us who are going through difficulties, we need to persevere. Maybe there are some of us who are facing roadblocks, we need to persevere. Let's pray. Father, we thank you, God, that when we look to you, we receive strength. Lord, when we turn away from the wind and the waves, when we look to you, we receive strength. Our faith is renewed, Lord. And so this today, we pray that this quality will be developed in us. This ingredient will be big in us, that we will persevere no matter what, that we will passionately hold on no matter what, that we will pursue and endure no matter what. And we pray that you will strengthen our hands, God, and we pray that we will realign, that we will refocus on who you are. We will refocus on your promises. And I pray that you will strengthen those of us who are weak, who need your strengthening. We give you all the praise and all the glory at this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally.
For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.